Welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God with Salami Energy Harina, your host. We are glad to have you today.
Hello, good day, and thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insight to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Tuesday, the 14th day of December 2021, and our topic for today is All Your Heart, Soul, and Mind. Let us pray. Everlasting Father, we thank you for such an awesome privilege to be gathered at your feet again. We thank you for your love, your grace, and mercy that has been lavishly showered upon us. Lord, we've come to seek your face again. We ask that you would send your word across our way. Let your word come to us with simplicity and with power. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God, you're welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Matthew chapter 22, verse 37. Matthew 22, verse 37 reads, Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. Matthew 22, verse 37. And our scripture reading for today is from the same book of Matthew chapter 22, reading from verse 35 to 38 now. Matthew 22, verse 35 to 38 reads, Then one of them, which was a lawyer, asked him a question, tempting him and saying, Master, which is the greatest commandment in the law? Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. God bless the reading of his word today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. You are welcome back. In the body of our devotional today, our Father in the Lord tells us, God wants you to be totally his. The Lord says in Exodus chapter 20 verse 3, Thou shalt have no other gods before me. There should be nothing standing between you and God. You shouldn't also allow anyone or anything take his place in your life. God must be your all in all. Beloved, you cannot claim to truly love God with all your heart, soul, and mind if anyone or anything is more important than him in your life. Jesus Christ described our memory verse today as the first and great commandment, Matthew 22 verse 38. It would hence amount to disobedience if you do not fulfill this commandment, and every transgression of God's commandment is sin, 1 John 3 verse 4. This then means that loving God with all our heart and soul and mind is not optional, but compulsory for all his children. You must therefore not set your heart on the material things of this life if you would please God. The Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 9 to 10, But they that will be rich fall into temptation and snare, and into many foolish and hurtful lusts, which drown men in destruction and perdition. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. The Lord Jesus further said in Matthew chapter 6 verse 24, No man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. Acknowledge the supremacy and excellence of the Almighty God, the Lord of the heavens and the earth at all times and in all you do. Beloved, God desires that you should set your heart, soul, and mind on him alone. This is the only way to be truly godly and to serve him acceptably. Every form of worldliness will eventually produce sin. Therefore, godliness and contentment must become your watchword. 1 Timothy 6 verse 6. May your service to him be acceptable from today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. God bless his word to us today. Hallelujah. The topic of our devotional today is All Your Heart, Soul, and Mind. Before we go further, I'd like us to establish one attribute of our God, and that is the sure fact that our God is a jealous God. This we can find him declare several times in scripture. In Exodus chapter 34 verse 14, for example, it reads, for thou shalt worship no other God. For the Lord, whose name is Jealous, is a jealous God. I'd also like to read from the New Living Translation. The New Living Translation reads, "You must worship no other gods but only the Lord, for He is a God who is passionate about His relationship with you." We can derive from that scripture that God's jealousy is about our relationship with Him. And one of the ways by which this jealousy can be ignited is by worshipping other gods. You'd agree with me that in these times that we are, it may no longer be common for people to bow down to objects and call them their God. The new form of idolatry that the enemy has craftily created is to make people worship things and sometimes to worship even fellow men, many times unconsciously. The enemy has become even more refined now in his approach because he understands the enlightenment of people and the times and seasons that we are. So the trick of the enemy is to place things in the lives of people which they will exalt above God in their lives. In our devotional today, our Father in the Lord says that there should be nothing standing between you and God. You shouldn't also allow anyone or anything take his place in your life. God must be your all in all. Whoever takes priority place in your heart becomes the one in charge. He becomes the master, and then you come under his control. When God is in charge as not only your Savior but your Lord as well, then you can be called his son. But when the enemy, the devil, is in charge, such an individual becomes his servant. You can even refer to him as his slave. And our enemy, the devil, is definitely not a good master. Our devotional today talks about all of our heart, our soul, and mind. This talks about the entirety of us. God wants everything submitted to him. He does not want a piece of us. He does not even want 99% of us. It is either everything or nothing at all. For every believer, it is expected that God is his priority, that God be number one, and nothing dares to compete with the place of God in that life. God's position in that life is unarguably secured. There is none before him and none beside him. Our Father in the Lord also mentions in today's devotional that loving God with all of our heart and soul and mind is not optional, but compulsory for all of his children. It is not an opinion, but a command. And we trust him for the grace today to love him with all of our heart and our soul and our minds in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. We also learned from our devotional today that to love God with all of our heart and our soul and our mind, we must ensure not to set our hearts on the material things of this life. And this is a very important point. Scripture tells us in Matthew chapter 6 verse 21 that for where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. If all you are concerned about is getting material possessions, your heart will definitely remain with those things here. But if you make seeking him first your priority, then you can be sure that you have your heart already set upon what really matters, and in the end, it would pay off. Never underestimate the power of focus. Our Lord Jesus also tells us in Matthew chapter 6 verse 24 that no man can serve two masters. You definitely love one and despise the other. So we must be very intentional in our choice to exalt Jesus in our lives above every other thing. It is a conscious effort. Before we go, I'd like to add quickly that for some people, it becomes difficult for them to love the Lord with all their heart and their soul and mind because of a blessing that the Lord himself has given to them. The same people cried and wept when they needed this blessing, but today it serves as a stumbling block. We must never let the same blessings that the Lord gives to us to become a reason why we cannot love him with all that we have. It is important that we also have at the back of our minds that if there is anything that you cannot let go for his sake, then you have not loved him with all of your heart, soul, and mind. Scripture tells us of God's example in John chapter 3 verse 16 that he loved the world so much he gave. He did not only give, he gave his only begotten son, and the reason was because of you and me, so that we may be saved. Today, you and I are evidences that when you give, you receive multiple folds as harvest. Our Lord Jesus was sown, and today we have such a great harvest. Hallelujah. We'd bow our heads today and ask the Lord, we'd say, "Father, grant me the grace to love you with all of my heart and all of my soul and all of my mind in the name of Jesus, asking for the grace to love Him with all that you have, to love Him with our bodies, our minds, our intellects, our gifts, our resources, our time, all that He has given to us. Pray and ask the Father that there will be nothing that we cannot lay down at His feet. Lord, the grace to truly love You with all of our hearts and our soul and mind. Help us to love You, Lord, indeed. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Our everlasting Father, the King of all ages, we thank You for all that You do for us. We thank You for loving us first. We come before You today in submission and we ask, Lord, that You take all that we have and make them Yours. Take all of our heart, our soul, and our mind. Use them as instruments. Let us be vessels unto honor to You. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have in our devotional today an action point that reads, determine to love God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind from today. And we trust Him that as we set our hearts to do so, He grant us the grace and enablement to love Him truly in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. In our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today, we read the entire book of 1 Peter. That is to say, we'll be reading from chapter 1 down to chapter 5. Praise God. It is such an awesome privilege to be sharing God's word with us again. We really want to appreciate you for joining us today. And we trust that you have been blessed. If you love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please do well to send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11 226. Also remember that you can be a blessing to someone today when you choose to share this word with them. As you go forth this day, may love and passion for God overwhelm you. May you love Him with all of your heart, your soul, and your mind in Jesus' name. Have a blessed day ahead. See you tomorrow again and bye for now.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.